Muy buenos días a todos los aquí
Good morning to
presentes.
all those who are here present.
De hoy domingo 18
Today, Sunday,
de agosto de este año
18th of August
2000,
of this year
2024. Es realmente una bendición y privilegio.
It is truly a blessing and a privilege
con el pueblo colombiano,
to be with the Colombian people,
con la bella Colombia,
with the beautiful Colombia,
y
and
el día de hoy,
to have
compañerismo alrededor
fellowship
de la palabra,
today around the word,
es la que corresponde,
which is the one that pertains
edad
to our age and our dispensation.
Lo que fue hablado por
what was spoken
profetas,
by the prophets,
lo que fue hablado
what was spoken
en el Antiguo Testamento,
in the
y en
Old
el Nuevo
Testament,
Testamento,
and in the New Testament,
que habría en el fin del tiempo,
that there would be at the end of time a revival
donde el pueblo
where
estaría de júbilo,
the people would rejoice.
Voy a treparme por aquí para
I'm going to climb over here. Amen. Wow. And we're going to
vamos a estar vamos a estar sin empujarnos para
we
que las personas
are going to be without pushing each other so that the older people They are around and also the kids. And this is the time when the jubilee of the bride would be impacting the world. Because at the time of Jesus, which was the fulfillment of the first coming of the Lord, in a simple man, in a construction worker, in the commonness of the people, there the religious leaders and the world, they were asking, what is the attraction on the mountain? Why is there so much noise and like an uproar? What happens is that they do not know about this revival that is in the soul, in the heart. They are the dewdrops trembling to return
a la casa del Padre Celestial,
the Heavenly Father's house,
de donde hemos venido,
from where we have come from. And
cuando se va acercando la mañana,
when the morning is approaching,
que fue uno de los primeros mensajes que hablé,
you know where that
decía,
was one of the
William,
first messages I spoke.
Yo puedo
I said to Brother William, I can go with you
favor,
as you tell
no
me, accompany you on the trips, but please don't make
no,
me to
no
talk.
Quiero, no me gusta.
I don't want
soy
to.
Tímido.
I don't like it. I'm shy.
No te preocupe.
He says, don't worry.
Era lo más que hacía.
And it was the most he would do.
Día,
I remember that day when
decía,
I said to him,
no me pase a
don't,
saludar,
me,
porque
don't make me come
no quiero, mano,
by
no,
to say hello, because I don't want to. And Brother William said no, and God put those words in my heart there,
me llegaron al
and they came to my mind, to my heart,
de las gotitas de rocío,
like dew drops.
Cuando está así amaneciendo,
when it is dawning,
empiezan a temblar, ustedes
they begin to
de
tremble.
De rocío.
And you look at the dewdrop,
ella sabe que el sol está
you
por
know
ahí,
that the sun is over there
asomándose,
picking it out.
Y saben que van a regresar pronto.
And they know that they are coming
eso,
back soon.
La pregunta en la primera venida del Señor,
that's why the question at the first
arriba,
coming of the Lord, what is the attraction
monte,
up there? What is the attraction on the mountain? Why so much excitement?
Estaba el pueblo bajo expectación,
the people were under expectation
de la llegada de
of the
ese personaje,
arrival of that character
a cabo la obra más grande,
who was going to carry out the greatest work and
iba a impactar el mundo
was going to impact the whole world
el cumplimiento
with
de esa labor.
The fulfillment of
que
that work,
llevar a cabo
which was carried out,
esa obra de sacrificio allí,
that work of sacrifice there,
la cual,
which
2000 años,
has been announced for approximately
siendo anunciado ese evangelio,
2000 years,
y ha impactado el
being
mundo.
Announced and it has impacted the world.
Iba a llegar el tiempo
but
en
you
que
notice
esa dispensación
the time
iba
was
cerrada,
going to come when that dispensation was going to close and a new dispensation, a new message
con el
would
cumplimiento
begin
de la venida,
with the fulfillment of the Son of Man with his angels.
Y el mismo que allá cerró
and the same one who closed the dispensation of the law
y abrió la dispensación de la gracia,
and opened the dispensation of grace
es el mismo hoy,
is the same today
que ha cerrado la dispensación de
who
la gracia,
has closed the dispensation of grace and opened
la dispensación de reino.
The dispensation of the kingdom.
Es el mismo yo soy,
it is the same I am
con un nombre nuevo,
with a new name.
Porque él cuando ascendió al cielo,
for when he ascended into heaven,
nuevo,
he received a new name.
Y no puede la humanidad decir
mankind
que eso
cannot say that this is not so. It is the Holy Scriptures,
nuevo,
there is a new name
Señor,
of the Lord.
Por consiguiente,
so therefore,
cuando él estaría revelando
when he would be revealing
pues
himself
venir,
at his coming,
con ese nombre
he has to come with that name that
no
he received.
Venir, con el mismo nombre Jesús,
he cannot come
Jesús,
with the same name Jesus because the entire world knows that name.
Ahora,
so now,
si me permiten por aquí compartirle,
if you allow me to share with you a portion of the message,
una porción del mensaje,
in the message,
¿cuál es la atracción en el monte?
What is the attraction on the mountain?
Predicado
preached
por nuestro hermano William Soto Santiago,
by our brother William Soto Santiago, and there's another one that
también,
Brother Branham preached also,
lo tituló,
that's what he titled it.
Y esto fue en el
1976, and this was in 1976 in April,
en donde en ese tiempo,
where at that time
se estaba llevando a cabo,
was taking place
lo que sería,
what would be
la realidad,
the reality
en el fin del tiempo,
at the end of time.
O sea, el cumplimiento pleno,
in other words, the full fulfillment of everything that happened and occurred in those first 3.5 years
de ese comienzo,
of the beginning,
desde el 1974
from 1974
al
1977.
To 1977. Y muchos,
and many of us did not understand what had happened at that time.
Eso estaba señalando,
that was pointing to
lo que sería,
what would be
en este tiempo final,
in this end time.
Y hoy,
and today,
estamos viendo,
we are seeing
ese cumplimiento,
that fulfillment
hecho realidad,
come true.
Todos los días,
all the days,
las horas, los minutos,
the hours, the minutes, the seconds that we are feeling and living today are what Brother Branham spoke of, what he
foreign,
and what our beloved Brother William Soto Santiago announced in those good tidings and such great news that he brought. Today,
siendo partícipes,
we are being participants
como actores,
as actors
de esa palabra que
of
fue
that
hablado,
word that was spoken.
Somos esa letra,
we
vida,
are that letter with life
que podemos respirar,
that we can breathe,
respirar,
look,
bendecirnos,
bless ourselves,
glorificar a Dios,
and glorify God.
O sea, que cuando nos miramos,
so that when we look at each other,
tercera etapa por toda
we
parte,
see the third pool everywhere.
Porque
because
la tercera etapa son
the third pool is you
yo,
and it is me.
No podemos decir,
we cannot say
mayor,
so and
o
so
más
is
grande,
greater or greater.
y el otro es más grande.
And the other one is greater, and this one is smaller. And that one is small. No, we are all equal.
Todos somos reyes.
We are all kings
y sacerdotes
and priests
del Dios Altísimo.
Of the Most High God.
Por lo tanto,
so therefore, the egos were going to gather where the word was incarnate. Where the dead body is, where the carcass is, there shall the egos gather. O egos of God, here we are today, a portion in every place, in every country, there are also egos gathering, receiving that rupturing faith to soon live here. The world will look and say, what's going on with those fanatics out there? They will call us all kinds of names. But God calls us His children. Amen. Well, so don't worry. I'm going to take them away right now.
Amen.
So hang in there for a little while. First you are going to rock this world, and then we shall be at the marriage supper of the Lamb. And that is just the beginning for a millennial kingdom that awaits us and an eternity. That is why it is worth it. It is worth it to fight. It is worth fighting for, worth persevering until all these promises are obtained. You notice here, Branham says, he's quoting the message, what is the attraction on the mountain? He says, what is the question today? What is the attraction on the mountain? And I ask you, I keep asking you, what is the attraction? What is it that attracts you? What is it that attracts you here in the Cornerstone Edge? What is it? Why don't you go down there? Why don't you go to the foot of the mountain? Why don't you go to the Laodicean Edge? Why don't you go there? Could it be that there is nothing that attracts you? Could it be that you were waiting for God to do something that He had promised? And when you see that He is fulfilling what He promised, then that is what attracts you? Amen. That is what attracts me. And that is what produces joy and rejoicing and jubilation. And that is what causes the tremendous jubilee, this tremendous rejoicing. And the egos, when they see and recognize what is happening at the top of the mountain, in the edge of the cornerstone, at the top of the mountain of Zion, when they see what is happening there, they do not recognize distances. Hey, how many here have come from very far? See? They don't recognize the distance. Or the climate either. But Branham says that the millennium will be with a temperature of about 70 degrees Fahrenheit or 21 degrees Celsius, something like that. So that's, yeah, it's about 60. This is in Fahrenheit. Yeah, it's centigrade, right? About 14 or 15. Yeah, it must be a little bit. What is it today? Today it's 8. Oh, it's a good temperature. Yeah, so we are fine. We are happy. They do not recognize distances. They do not recognize distances because they are drawn to what God is doing there in the edge of the cornerstone. Because they desire to hear God speak. Amen. And God has already spoken in past ages a portion of what He was going to speak. But in the cornerstone edge, on top of the mountain, there is God speaking to His people everything that had never been made known to the children of God before.
Dios está hablando
there,
en su
God is speaking in his fullness.
Dios está
there, God is moving in all his fullness. No other of the edges had he done it that way. But in that edge of the cornerstone, for those who are there, it is a reason to rejoice. Because they can see and hear God manifesting himself and speaking, because that is what he was doing there. Below was that they needed to see physical miracles, but above, those who were there were brought there to hear God and see God. Remember the third pole, the most important thing is the word. Amen. After you have that word, which is the one that gives the rapture in faith, the next thing is already additions.
And
then if you want to see miracles, you are going to see many miracles. But what good is it to have and want to see miracles first? You got the miracle. What are you going to do now? See? When that blind man was healed, then when he put the mud on his eyes, he spat on the ground and made some mud and put it in his eyes, he received his sight. But afterwards he died. In other words, a physical miracle, you notice, for those times, even in the time of the fulfillment of the coming of the Lord in his first coming, then afterwards they were going to die. Now at this time, our eyes, both spiritual and physical, most of them will not see death. In other words, our eyes will never close. There is only one whose eyes will be closed for 3.5 days. It's a short time, but for most of the sons and daughters of God, their eyes, both spiritual and physical, will not close. I pray to God that soon that number will be completed, because we do not want them to continue to leave us. Because while we are in these bodies, there is still a number there that has not been completed. And you cannot get to that place and have the judgment that you are going to have there. Those ministries without the last person who is due to be there arrives. So therefore the last one that is going to arrive there is Revelation 11. And after that, if there is anyone who in those days has to give his life for something that is happening on earth, I wait for him. I wait for him there, because he will not remain without returning. And if he is one of those who will return for transformation, for resurrection and rapture, then he will return. Now all those are mysteries which are being opened clearly. And we are understanding them. And we do not say as Peter said, look, such a thing shall not happen to you. Rather, as humans, we know all that hard stage that is going to come. It is very, very hard. And there we have to see who has his pants, the men and women, the dresses, in the right place. And there, we will have that last test. If we really loved God, loved his coming, and did not run away on that occasion as they did over there, leaving him alone.
But
blessed be God that at this time they will not leave the fulfillment of his coming alone. Because amen. You are gaining all the knowledge
that
was not had in the past times. You are becoming open books.
todo el conocimiento.
In other words, all the knowledge of God
y su programa,
and His program.
Cada hijo de Dios,
every child of God is having it completely.
Y al uno tener el conocimiento del,
and as one has the knowledge of the prophecies and the fulfillment of them and everything that is going to happen, we can only say, Lord, may thy will be done. And that strength that Jesus needed there in Gethsemane, you notice even there, they left him alone. They did not even pray for him. They fell asleep. But here there are people awake who will be hand in hand with that ministry until they reach that great victory in love divine. Now he says, therefore being there, being happy, and rejoicing, what's the attraction? The world may say, they don't know, but you who are there, you know what the attraction is. That little group that has come out with a cry, that with that message, proclaiming Him King of Kings and Lord of Lords, proclaiming Him Son of David. And what else do they proclaim? It says, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord, proclaiming that he has come with the name of the Lord. That is the eternal name of God. That is the message, the cry that that little group has. And where are they going? Where is he going? He's coming from one place, but he is going to introduce, to be introduced to Jerusalem. The introduction is being made. The introduction to everything of the future is being made here. This little group is introducing this world, is introducing Israel, and is introducing in every way the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and has crowned him in the top of the mountain, in the top part of the pyramid. Now you notice where that Holy Spirit is, that the Reverend William Branham spoke, when this Holy Spirit that we have becomes incarnate, the one that is in our midst right now. Now you notice he was working through the Reverend William Branham, but he was in mercy. And to be crowned as King of Kings and Lord of Lords would have to be in the dispensation of the kingdom. So therefore, in none of the messengers was the Holy Spirit crowned. He has and had to be crowned in the cornerstone age and the dispensation of the kingdom. And all that was shown in types and figures in time past, today, it's becoming a reality. Today, that scripture has been fulfilled. The crowning of that ministry is the knowledge of the people who know where God is at, working, and have identified Him in His coming as the Son of David. They are on their way to sit him on the throne of David. And you know what? That those who are campaigning for some president, and when that president wins, those who that president has next to him are the ones who were hand in hand with him in struggles, in battles, with cold, with everything that can happen, with hunger. But in the end, oh, blessed be God. The victory and what we are going to receive is something so great that it is not compared to everything we can go through on this earth. So those are the ones that Brother William was telling us in the messages, that is in that time of the millennium reign and eternity. God was going to have cross all those brave men of David who fought and stood hand in hand to sit him on the throne of David. So do not look for who you are. You are yourselves. Amen. You look at each other and each one will say, King, Queen, hey, we have very little left. And the important thing, amen, was to identify him. We have been in expectation for years. And we are looking where Lord, here we have what you have promised. And going firm, holding on to this messenger. But you notice, that was what each and every one of us thought with our brother William. And God takes him away. Ah, but what happened here?
Ahí empieza esa media hora de silencio.
There begins that half hour of silence.
En un momento dado allí,
in a given moment there, it has already
claro,
been spoken quite clearly.
Ver,
because when you can see that overlap
hora,
of what that half hour is,
tiempo,
and you can know
ahí,
the time there,
empezó,
in that overlap
puede,
that began,
ya,
you can already have enough knowledge
de lo que
of what Brother Branham on page 23-27 in the 70 weeks of Daniel said that he would not miss a minute. He would not miss a minute. So therefore God begins the half hour and something begins to move on earth. It is the seventh seal being manifested on earth in an instrument. And a revival begins, an awakening, and the word begins to produce that revival. And we don't know what it is, but we know that there was something going on among the people, and apparently something terrible had happened, which hurt us very much. Look, if one suffered that, it was me. I lived it alone. And then, when he showed me everything, oh, blessed be God, I said, rightly so. And then the sadness turned into joy, into happiness. Because I said, look, I said, Lord, thank you because you showed me that there is a people that would receive your coming and that you left them well prepared. And all we had to do was to turn the switch and it was opened. Hey, but there's an open door. So we went there. Come up here, boys, to hear what you want to hear and what you wanted to hear. It was the rapturing faith. It was that which had not been spoken, which he said, this we are not going to speak. This we are going to leave alone. We cannot say this. And now this is like this, this is like this, this is like this. Now it is spoken clearly. It is spoken so clearly that we can see the seventh seal working in the midst of the people. And there is the identification of that ministry. Now you notice, for that to happen, Gabriel would have to leave. He could not stay with Mary there. He had to leave for that son to be born later. But he was not alone. His entire ministry was with him. But you notice, from the day he was born, he took care of him. He protected him until the day he began his ministry. And from then on, he carried out that work of 3.5 years. which was the work that he later crowned on the cross. But you notice that that archangel was always with Jesus, though not in the way Mary was seeing him there, in a conversation of a common, in such a manifestation, perhaps many never see him. That was for Mary. Notice, for the spiritual Mary, we had him among us, talking to us all this time. But the moment was coming when that son was already grown up. He had taught him well.
Ya lo había preparado.
And he had already prepared
bueno,
him.
Ahora te toca a ti.
Well, now it's your turn to follow.
Y yo le dije, y en claro,
and I told him very clearly,
yo,
said,
yo voy a toda,
I decir, go to all.
Como decimos allá.
As we say there.
Pero tienes que estar conmigo.
But you have to be with me.
No me puedes dejar solo.
Can't leave me alone. Then he told me, do not worry, I will be with you all the days of your life.
Amen.
He's with us.
He's
the Holy Spirit in the midst of the people, working and carrying out what was promised. Now, you notice here another little place where he referred to Brother Branham. He said there, quoting from that page 7 of the message, What is the Attraction on the Mountain? He says, for many of the people, being spiritual minded, knew that he was the Passover lamb, because he had already told them the things that was going to happen. And then, of course, knowing that he was to be there, and loved him the way they did, they was waiting for him. There was a crowd that was probably pushing, shoving from one gate to the other one. There was like a push in the places too. But we are aware that the rejoicing and the joy, and we put it that way, but we must also be careful with children and adults.
And
when we go out, then live very carefully. Remember, we have a millennium and an eternity to be together. In other words, these little moments should be well used. We wish there is no misfortune, but we protect each other and we help each other, and we spend time and beautiful moments that then we take in our hearts and we meditate upon them, which in the millennium and eternity we remember these moments. They say, I was there in history. Remember the book of Acts. The continuation is this time. Amen. In other words, you are going to appear there in Scripture as one of those who was in that revival that will not stop. This will continue growing and growing until it will come to the moment when the resurrection will occur and the transformation. There's a place in the book of quotation that speaks,
there
will be a time where the pillar of fire will be moving. It will be a matter of months, something like that. It will be something of months, something that will go around the world. Now it says here, watching out in every way. For they knew that one of the hours he would appear, they were watching. Others were wondering what was the matter with these people running from gate to gate. What's the attraction? And they would look this way and look that way to find out.
It
looked like they were looking for something, an expectation of something going to happen. Oh, I would like to change my text for a few minutes and say this, that that's what the matter today. The people who are looking for him coming is under great anticipation and expectations. We can feel it, the pressure. And they are seeking, watching every move and every sign, comparing it with the scriptures. Because that is what the people were supposed to do when he left. He had repeatedly told us, look into the messages of Brother Branham, for as he said, it would be his coming. This is exactly how it will be fulfilled. Have the book of quotations, the seals, the edges, the 7 weeks of Daniel. Have the messages that were preached, especially from 1963 to 65. And one said, but why does he send us there to read all those messages? Brother William Marion Branham is the forerunner of the second coming of the Lord. So therefore, to identify the coming of the Lord, as one has to go to the messages that were preached, which were pointing out the coming of the Son of Man with his angels, and how it would be. And he would repeat to us, said, that message is in effect. Watch it, because you are going to find how God would be carrying out that promise. Because if you do not watch, you will overlook it. How many times did he say that? Lots of times. And one said, but how can it be overlooked it if there is Brother William? Well, yeah, he's there, so I will not be overlooked. Hey, you have to be watchful. And what does Brother Branham say? See the fulfillment of what is going on and go to the scriptures. Wait, I don't like that way of being very much. But here it is in the scriptures that what would be happening. But I am feeling a revival. That I had not felt it before. Ha. To one. There's a message here too, but we read it later, which speaks of the edict following the fulfillment. And if he has to follow, and the shame follows also, something like that. So the part, let's say, people are negative, we also follow. Because you notice Jesus was searched for faults, and they found them, those who looked for faults. He who wants to search will find them. But the elect, what they are looking for is a blessing. The blessing of God. Because if we are looking at that, then we would have to walk with our eyes closed, because we are still in these bodies. But God is merciful. He who has left the ministry of Moses and Elijah for the people who would be receiving these ministries, what does he say there? Who wrote with his own hand? Moses and Elijah. He who receives his message receives mercy. Then to those of the third pool, those who have the word of the third pool, wherever we look at each other, we look at mercy everywhere. Look at your wife, your children, your friends, your companions, your brethren of the congregation. Look upon them with eyes of mercy. For if the word of Moses and Elijah is in you, you must have mercy. Amen. So look at the power that God is giving to his children. His elect. Will not a family have chance? There is expression of mercy, so therefore bear with each other. We forgive each other. Because do not believe that there will be a little situation there. Take me to that corner because I don't get along with that guy. Well, look, they are going to be like that, then one of the two is going to stay, or both. So we solve things here. Let's stop the nonsense, the childishness. We are no longer children or bottle babies. We are eating solid food. It is already algebra, trigonometry, and up there everything like that. Oh, may God bless you. I'm glad to see all of you. I'm so glad. to see all of you. It's a joy.
Aquí ya sigue diciendo.
And a joy to see you. In,
oh, ¿cómo desearía yo cambiar
mi texto? It says, oh, how I would like to change my text for a few minutes.
Eso es lo que pasa hoy
and say this, that is what's the matter today. The people who are looking for him coming in under great anticipation and expectation. You can feel it, the pressure. And they are seeking, watching every move and every sign, comparing it to the scriptures. And when they see all these things that was predicted of him, right up in the end, they know it. The end was near. They wanted to be there, so they watched. And we know that it is very near. It is very close. The fulfillment, all those prophecies and promises that are yet to be fulfilled, which the one we are longing for is to see again those who have departed. The resurrection, that will be so beautiful. Because he said, look how the resurrection moves. So, it will be at times when the people are in that expectation. And in that revival, at that stage already, at such a high level, that when we look, hey, what a young man. What are you doing here? Don't you remember that I am your dad? Or your mom? Ah, how can it be possible? And what are you doing here in this service? And for that moment, the group is filling up. And these young people are over there or appearing. And at that moment, you say to them, hey, but you look too perfect. You said to you, well, but this is what was promised. And have you not taken a look at yourself as well? He said, oh, but what happened to me? That's something so fast, so quick. You won't notice it. It's a blink of an eye. It's a flash. We will be changed. And it says the gray hair will go away. Oh, I'm already getting a few there. That one accommodates them. And if they come out more accommodates them. And that's the list. He says that not a hair will perish. Now, that will be such a glorious moment of that group of young people who will be already in the eternal and glorified bodies. That there will be that great gathering in this end time, which will never separate us. It will be for all eternity. This, which I quoted to you on paragraph 507, says, I believe that we still have great light coming on now that will just flood the earth one of these days for a short period. Maybe just in a matter of months. But I believe that there is a great light coming. There's one that says, the great light. A light will come that will take us. When that persecution comes, don't be afraid. For a short time. You always told me, get ready for 6 months.
Oh.
Now what are the 6 months? What 6 months? Can that be? So we must be with our spiritual eyes wide open, and also what those 6 months represent. Because you notice after that ministry, had 3 years after he was adopted on the Mount of Transfiguration, 6 months he carried out a work, and then the cross. So you have to see what all that represents there. The important thing is to be in that revival, to be part of that revival, because the revival is you. It is the people. And what is it that revives the people? The word, the revelation. Therefore, if the word has no place to be, it's not revived. Sure. But once it is placed in a good soil, in a good land, that revives that person. And there is the revival. What's the fuss up there? What are those people doing up there? Who even though they have many situations, but they are happy. Amen. And they get sad about some situation, but then you see them getting happier. What do they have there? It's for a revival, that awakening which was promised, which is being expressed in human beings. And there it says, on paragraph 1054, it says, when that persecution comes, don't get scared. There is a light. Said he would catch his people away. Now, if he says that there is a light that will take away his children, he said the pillar of fire would be that was the pillar of fire that the Reverend William Branham saw in the vision of the tent. So therefore, we are sure. We are sure we have nothing more and nothing less than the pillar of fire that delivered the Hebrew people, that guided them in the wilderness and brought them into the promised land. To the same pillar of fire, it is today in the midst of the people, guiding us to the promised land of the new body. She will not go through the tribulation. She will never do it. He said she wouldn't. She will be caught away. So soon, all the scriptures will be fulfilled fully. On the top of the mountain, there is the attraction. There is that God is working in the midst of the people. What is the attraction on the mountain? For the attraction is that there is the coming of the Lord and the people who would receive him. That is the attraction. You are an attraction on the mountain. So may God bless you and keep you. And we will see each other in the service within a couple of hours, where we hope that God will give us much word, so that that word may be incarnated in our hearts, and let us grow today more, that faith may grow more, and that everything you came to look for in this service, amen, that you will have today, you will have it today, you find it. Much spiritual revelation, spiritual healing, and physical healing as well. Believe it with all your heart. There's nothing impossible for a believing child of God. Everything is possible for the believer. So, Colombian people, may God have that beautiful Colombia, be part of that glorious millennial kingdom into the millennium, and be a country of great blessing for the kingdom of God, for the Messiah's kingdom. May God bless the beautiful Colombia. God bless the beautiful Colombians. May God bless Latin America and the Caribbean. Amen. May God bless you and keep you. And give us a little chance with prudence. There we settle down on the sides, and we'll go out. God bless you, because the feet, if they put them under the wheel, they can be caught, and we do not want it to get there. So please, let's be wise people. I don't know if it's already open. They are going to open. They are going to open, so go carefully. If you are going on foot, then go carefully. There is still darkness, and cars are passing, so we will stand and wait as long as we have to wait, so that everything will be settled, so there's no need to hurry. God bless you and keep you, and I always love you with my heart. May God bless you. See you later. Amen.